everyone in Connecticut, everyone everywhere needs an affordable home. Problem is, in Connecticut, too many people don't have it. 49% of renters and 30% of homeowners are burdened by their housing costs. That means they're paying more than 30% of their income for housing. That's bad for them because they have very little left over for food, clothing, healthcare, transportation, other vital needs. And it's bad for the state's economy because they're left with much too little discretionary income to support local merchants and the business community in general. But it gets worse. A lack of affordable choices widens the achievement gap. It's really bad if parents cannot live in communities that are good for their kids and provide school opportunities that are good for their kids. It hurts the environment. Housing that's not built in the right locations promotes sprawl, excessive auto emissions, wastes energy. It also clogs roads. People have to drive too far. It doesn't support mass transit, walkable communities, and bicycle use. It also prevents parents and children from accessing health care, child care, fresh food, other vital needs and services that come up every day that they need. There is, however, good news. The good news is more community leaders are realizing that the lack of affordable housing is hurting Connecticut. Business leaders understand that they can't get skilled labor to come to Connecticut. We've seen that with GE, we've seen that with Aetna. And the reason is that even though Connecticut's a high wage state, housing costs are so high that young professionals net out less money, less discretionary income, and thus they either don't come here or they don't stay. Also recognizing the problem are doctors and healthcare experts. Doctors are recognizing that unless you can afford an affordable home, you have less money left over for food, clothing, those other expenses. If you live in substandard housing, there are dust mites, lead paint, broken pipes, lots of problems. If you can't afford to live in the right neighborhood or the right school district for your family, it's bad for mental and physical health and development. In the same way, nutritionists understand that access to fresh food is important for children to develop and for overall family health. Educators understand that if parents can't live and afford to live in a community that provides the schools with the programs their children need, those kids cannot do well on reading and math tests. We've seen that research shows that if you can live in a high-resource school district, reading and math scores go up. At the same time, baby boomers, without much in the way of retirement savings, need a smaller, more affordable, walkable home to downsize into. Their children, the millennials, have a lot of education debt, and they need the same type of smaller, denser, more affordable place to live. I know that doesn't sound like good news, but it is good news. It is because more constituencies are sensitized and open to hearing about a solution, and that is a greater supply of affordable homes in many more communities around the state. We think municipalities will respond, that this campaign can move them. The problem is that we are right now facing a lot of people who don't understand the message. On the other hand, fortunately, we are finalizing our second decade Home Connecticut 2.0 agenda. We will have an agenda ready for a campaign statewide. We can parlay the campaign's impact into new housing creation. So we believe time is right for a campaign that builds that kind of momentum. And so, the bottom line, we can do it. We know what to do. We know what we need to do. We have the arguments and the data to back it up. Now we need to consult communications and marketing experts so we can learn the optimal messages, the optimal mediums, and the scientifically superior methods to reach people. We've been told that $20,000 will fully support a complete plan. We know the people to talk to, and I think with your support, we can get this done.
Action.
I need to go to makeup before this.
I gotta stop.